Let the countdown begin.
Number 40.
The first of our two debuts is the first American hit for a Canadian singer named Celine Dion. She's already had 5 number one singles in Canada, and now she's out to make her mark in the USA as well. Here's Where Does My Heart Beat Now?
So much to believe.
I'm Shadoe Stevens, American Top 40. This is another debut. It's by a French-Canadian singer. Her name is Celine Dion. She comes in at number 39 with Where Does My Heart Beat Now?
Casey's Top 40.
I'm Casey Kasem, counting down the 40 biggest hits in the 50 state. Well, now we're up to a singer who's had 4 platinum albums and 5 number one singles. Yet most Americans have never heard of her. So she's starting her career all over again. Her name is Celine Dion, and she's a 23-year-old singer from the French-speaking Canadian province of Quebec. There, she's considered a superstar. People mob her in public asking for autographs. She's been making hits in Quebec for 10 years now, since she was 13 years old. And besides the number one singles and platinum albums, she's also won 15 Felix Awards, Quebec's equivalent of the Grammy. But even with all that success at home, Celine says she's always wanted one thing more, to be a star in the USA. All Celine's hits were in French, and until a couple of years ago, she couldn't even speak English. She knew that if she wanted to make it in the USA, she couldn't count on her superstar reputation in Canada. She says she told herself, quote, "I'm going to have to forget that I'm known and look at it as a new career, starting all over again." So, Celine hired some top U.S. record producers. She changed her image to something she hoped U.S. fans would like, from a sweet, innocent-looking girl to a beautiful, more sophisticated woman. Finally, Celine took a 2-month crash course in English to learn the language of the new fans she'd hoped she'd have. With all that preparation under her belt, Celine recorded her very first English-language album, called Unison. She released a single in the U.S. and sat back to wait for the results. Well, she didn't have to wait long. That very single hit the top 40 3 weeks ago, and already it's at number 13.
Casey's Top 40.
I'm Casey Kasem. Casey's Top 40 originates in Hollywood. Now, we're up to the second American hit for a 23-year-old from Canada, a woman who's already a superstar in her homeland with 9 giant albums spread out over the past 10 years. Her name is Celine Dion, and she's been a star for virtually her whole life. You see, Celine comes from a very musical family. They're one of the most famous and beloved musical touring acts in the French-speaking area of Canada. As the youngest of 14 children, Celine says her very first childhood memories are of her family singing on stage. And it wasn't very long before Celine joined them. By the time she was 5 years old, she'd become the youngest performing member of the Dion family. And Celine wasn't meant to be stuck in the back either. Like Michael Jackson in the Jacksons, she quickly moved out in front and made a name for herself. By the time she was 12 years old, Celine had earned herself a recording contract, and she quickly became the darling of the French-Canadian music world. Over the past 10 years, she's recorded 9 albums in French, and every single one of those albums has been a huge hit. They've earned her an unprecedented 15 Felix Awards, the French-Canadian equivalent of the Grammy. That's more than anyone else. Recently, Celine added a 10th album to that collection. Only, in a way, this 10th album is also her first. Her first album recorded in English. The album's called Unison, and it's already given Celine her first top 10 in the USA. Where Does My Heart Beat Now? This week, Celine's back in the countdown with a follow-up to that top 10 smash with If There Was Any Other Way.
Bonjour, Shadoe. It's Celine Dion. I would love to go on an AT40 flashback.
Well, there's no time like the present, so in goes the coin. And we're off. Navigating the time stream of songs gone by till we plunge into the watery spray and foamy joy of another AT40 flashback.
Non-stop hop to the
Celine Dion has a hit at number 23, If You Asked Me To. It's another Diane Warren song, and Celine told us a little bit about it.
Diane Warren just presented me a lot of songs, and in there was If You Asked Me To. So I went in the studio and I started to record the song, and someone told me that, yeah, that song has been recorded by Patti LaBelle many years ago. And I said, what? This song? Really? The most important thing for me is to love my music, to like the songs that I'm singing. An old song or a new song, doesn't matter. If I'm happy and I sing songs that I enjoy, That's the most important thing.
If You Ask Me To, Celine Dion's number 3 song ends up at 23 for 1992.
Hi, this is Celine Dion. These are the 100 top hits of the past year, all the way to number 1 on American Top 40. Shadoe's coming right back with more of the year's biggest songs.
Sitting in for Casey Kasem, this is Mark Elliott. Now, we're up to the latest hit for a French-Canadian superstar who sang the theme from Flashdance on stage for 5 years. And that was before she finally learned enough English to discover what the words to the song meant. She's Celine Dion, and she grew up in the fiercely nationalistic Canadian province of Quebec. In fact, she grew up in a small town in rural Quebec where the only language spoken was French. Until recently, Celine had no understanding of English at all, and almost all the songs she sang for the first 10 years of her career were in French. But back in 1983, her manager decided it would be a good idea for Celine to do one song in English, to test the English language waters. The song he decided on was the big Irene Cara hit Flashdance, What a Feeling. The words were fairly simple, and Celine learned them phonetically, even though she didn't understand them. For the next 5 years, she performed Flashdance in her shows, without having a clue as to what she was singing about, which Celine now says must have been pretty comical. Looking back, she says she put her emphasis on all the wrong words, making the song sound pretty strange to those who understood English. Finally, in the late 80s, her manager decided it was time for Celine to go for success on the American charts, and that's when she learned to speak and sing in English. The result has been a string of big hits in the USA, including the song that climbed 6 notches to number 16 on Casey's Top 40. Here's Celine Dion with Love Can Move Mountains.
She's up for 3 Grammys this year, including Record of the Year for Beauty and the Beast. Celine Dion moves up 5 to 24 with her latest Love Can Move Mountains.
Hi, this is Celine Dion. This week's AT40 sneak peek is on the way. I don't want to miss it, and neither do you.
Casey's Top 40.
Sitting in for Casey Kasem, I'm David Perry. These are the hits you're buying and radio stations are playing from coast to coast. Now we're up to the latest hit for a singer who says she doesn't drink, she doesn't go to clubs, she doesn't even eat chocolate. Her only vice? She lives to shop. And when Celine Dion says she lives to shop, she means she lives to shop. She calls herself a shopping addict and a crazy person for shopping. She says it's her favorite thing in the world. And there are good reasons that she loves shopping so much. You see, Celine grew up the youngest of 14 children in Quebec. Her father was a prison guard and then a lumberjack, which means there wasn't all that much money to buy things. Celine grew up wearing hand-me-downs from her many sisters. In fact, since there were 9 girls in the family, about the only clothing that Celine ever got to buy new was underwear and socks. Everything else came from her older siblings. When Celine would go to stores with her mother and sisters, she dreamed about buying new things for herself. And when she finally became a star, it was clothing that became her obsession. An obsession that these days she can well afford. How much does Celine love to shop? Well, she says she's got somewhere between 300 and 400 pairs of shoes and probably the same number of dresses. She doesn't even know how many pairs of slacks and sweaters she owns. She says she really hasn't changed all that much. She still has her feet on the ground. She's just wearing better shoes these days. This week, that very well-dressed singer steps up 12 notches to number 17 on Casey's Top 40. Here's Celine Dion with The Power of Love.
It's Celine Dion, and you're listening to the biggest countdown in all the world, American Top 40 with Shadoe Stevens.
American Top 40.
Next at 15, a lady who has 2 singing careers going, one in English and one in French. Makes sense when you're from French Canada, Quebec. But it seems like Celine Dion's been doing nothing but English songs lately, so we asked her about it.
Well, I continue to sing in French. I have a new French album. When I perform, I sing in both languages all the time, still. It's not because I'm singing in English that I'm going to stop singing French. French is my first language, and I'm very proud of it. If I can do both all my life, I will.
The whispers in the morning.
Celine Dion's from Charlemagne, Quebec, 30 miles outside Montreal, for those of you who like playing with maps. Her 8th Top 40 hit, The Power of Love, climbs from 19 to 15.
Hi, it's Celine Dion. More great songs are coming up on American Top 40.